Good evening. New developments in the civil case involving the death of a Tallahassee police informant. A jury has now been seated for trial, but this case may not make it that far. Eyewitness News reporter Julie Montanaro joins us live now from City Hall to tell us why.
That's right. There is a closed-door executive session right now among city commissioners and city attorneys, and we understand they are discussing a possible settlement in the Rachel Hoffman case. Now, as you can see, we have our cameras outside that fourth-floor conference room. Inside the doors, the mayor, city commissioners, city attorneys, the city manager, and the city police chief. We understand they are discussing a possible settlement in the Rachel Hoffman case. We are standing by here at City Hall for more information. Now, just minutes before that meeting started, attorneys seated a jury in the civil suit. It includes 8 women and 1 man. Among the jurors, a UPS driver, an educator, and an engineer. Testimony in that case is slated to begin Monday and last for a month. Now, of course, the big question tonight is this closed-door meeting here at City Hall. Will that result in some type of last-minute settlement, or will this case go forward to the jury on Monday morning? We'll be standing by live here at City Hall to let you know. This meeting expected to last about an hour, they say. So we'll be standing by and let you know what happens. Reporting live at Tallahassee City Hall, I'm Julie Montanaro, WCTV Eyewitness News.
First, a Gadsden County man is accused of sneaking into a neighbor's barn and having sex with a horse. It is the second time that Patrick Lynn has been arrested for it, and the owner of that horse can hardly believe Lynn would return to the scene of the crime.
I had a feeling he'd be back because I believe it's a compulsion type thing with him.
Alan McDermott says he knew there was trouble when his wife went to the barn and noticed some lubricant on the stall door.
She then checked the horse, and I went down and checked the security video, and sure enough, there he was going into the stall.
Deputies say Patrick Lynn was caught on tape sneaking into McDermott's barn in the wee hours of Sunday morning. Lynn has been charged with trespassing, burglary, and sex acts with animals.
Oh, that's so good.
This animal, a stud horse named Sonny. It comes 2 years after Lynn was caught on tape and arrested for doing the same thing. Same barn, different horse. The McDermotts and just about everyone else around here can't believe Lynn would return knowing there were cameras. The next night, deputies waited for Lynn. They wound up chasing him through the woods and arresting him in front of his own house more than a mile away. Lynn told them he'd been out for a walk.
The guy knows right from wrong, or he wouldn't be running like he does, but he ain't totally right for what he's doing. I think he needs help, and he needs be put away so he can't do anything like that.
And Lynn is currently being held without bond in the Gadsden County Jail.
2 people were shot outside a Tallahassee Walmart this afternoon. It brought Black Friday shopping to a terrifying halt.
Those shots were fired in front of the store on Appalachie Parkway just after noon, and just minutes ago, police confirmed that the folks were fighting over a parking space.
The shots were fired on the sidewalk right in front of the Parkway Walmart. Police are still trying to find out who fired them.
It's scary, especially in front of a store where people can get hurt, you know. I mean, it's scary and stupid.
Witnesses tell us 2 couples were arguing. At some point, a shopping cart hit the side of the car, and a man stepped out and started shooting.
On scene, officers located 2 victims who have suffered non-life-threatening injuries and are currently being treated at a local hospital.
Stunned shoppers stood outside. Customers who were inside say they heard the shots and people started running.
And I heard the muffled sounds of shooting. It sounded like 5 times. People started running towards the back of the store. Apparently something summoned people in quite a shock.
Officers say the whole thing may have been caught on tape by surveillance cameras overhead. The Walmart shut down for more than 2 hours. Customers coming to check out Black Friday bargains were stunned to find out 2 people had been shot amidst the crowd.
Sad, bad, scary. Got to be careful these days what's going on. Cause we could have been here a little earlier than what we did, but thank God we just got here on the end of it.
Well, here's hoping none of you ever wind up behind bars, but in Tallahassee, about 1,000 people a month do. So what happens beyond those gates? We're taking you behind the scenes tonight to get booked. There's no placard hanging around their neck these days. Mugshots are digital now, and correctional officers at the jail are more interested in documenting your tattoos than your profile.
Tell you about it to the side.
It's 11 o'clock on a Wednesday morning. This man is accused of violating his probation. The one down the hall is charged with domestic violence. The Leon County Sheriff's Office books nearly 50 inmates every single day.
Take each hand, put it on the wall.
It all starts out here. Everyone is patted down. Those charged with felonies can expect a strip search and cavity check.
And what's the most common kind of contraband that you do find when you're doing these searches?
A lot of times it's going to be marijuana or cocaine. We have found cell phones and other things.
The ink and roll is long gone too. All fingerprints are digital, and once they're in, they lead to a world of information in a matter of minutes.
When we put the fingerprints in, within 5 minutes, we'll be able to tell whether they've ever been arrested in the state of Florida or anywhere in the United States. After that, and we run the what we have called a state ID number, we'll be able to tell whether there's warrants out for them.
You can find the Leon County Jail booking report on our website every day. Thursdays and Fridays are usually the busiest.
A spot check of today's booking report shows 45 arrests, 8 of them for drugs, followed by grand theft, burglary, DUI, trespassing, and sex crimes. 7 people were pegged with VOPs, or violations of probation. Correctional officers say as many as 1/3 of the folks in jail at any given time are here for that.
But if you do not have the money, you will not be denied medication or health care.
No matter what you're in for, you'll see the nurse. She checks and documents any injuries or medical conditions. You'll receive a wristband with a barcode and have the opportunity to make one free 1-minute phone call. Any other calls will have to be made collect from a payphone in a holding cell. And in here, you never know who could be sitting next to you.
They all go into these holding cells right here for our main population, unless they're violent charges. They go down to our other holding cells where we have bars, if they're combative, or DUIs that are extremely intoxicated where they don't need to be around other people.
When that door slams, they know they're in jail. And then sometimes you see them cry, sometimes you just see them drop their head. It's that reality check there.
Standards say people cannot be held in holding cells for more than 8 hours unless they're drunk. And when you leave here, it's either to post bond or get your jail-issue pillowcase, which comes complete with a toothbrush, blanket, and a list of all the rules.
Now, both the famous and the infamous have walked through the gates of the Leon County Jail. Officers have certainly heard the stories about Jim Morrison and Ted Bundy, but as for the ones they have booked themselves, officers were quick to recall Governor Bush's daughter, convicted cop killer Coy Evans, but all of them agreed it was death row inmate Gary Michael Hilton they will never forget.
And probably nobody wants to go through what you showed them, so not a bad idea,
no,
right?
No, indeed. And I was shocked at the volume of people who come through on any given day. 40 to 50 people every single day
wow.
are arrested and wind up in jail.
The family is gearing up for a big birthday party as their quadruplets turn 1.
We first met the Lunsfords in the neonatal unit the day after those babies were born, and today we had a chance to visit their crib, literally.
Adeline, Blythe, Calligale, and Drew peered out over the edge of their cribs, tiptoeing to get a closer look at the man with the camera. They're all happy, healthy, and learning to walk. The quads were born a year ago, 3 identical girls and a boy, all weighing between 2 and 4 pounds.
Thank you, God. This is so awesome. We're going to have 4 babies. That is so cool.
1 year later, what do you say? Same thing.
Yeah, it's still awesome. And he gave us 4 great babies.
We just do it. We work together and we make it happen.
The only way to do it is to do it together.
Couldn't do it without each other.
Yeah.
We go through a whole one of these and a little bit of another one every day.
Got it.
Here we go. It's our baby food collection. We feed them around 10 jars a day is about what we go through.
And mm-hmm. How many diapers a day?
16 to 20 a day.
Are y'all broke all the time?
Yeah. Yeah, we are, especially with him being a teacher, you know. But we make it.
The quads can't go anywhere without drawing a crowd.
People pretty well surround us. We have to bring a lot of time with us because people stop and talk and ask a lot of questions, which is fine. We don't mind. They're such a joy to us that it's fun for us to share with everyone else.
Yeah.
And despite the rigorous routine of feedings, diaper changes, naps, and baths, their parents still seem to be pinching themselves 1 year later.
reminds us that what's important in life is the love that we have. So it's pretty cool.
And it is pretty cool. I had so much fun at their home today. A big party at their church is planned tomorrow.
Wow. Very expensive, though, I'm sure.